Right, let's move on with part two. Raise folding as your friend, right? That really is. That's I used to just fold. I used to think, yeah, let's just play tight. Let's just fold. But no, it's good because not only that, you're actually you'll get less respect for when you do actually have a decent hand as well. So as I say, usually it's when late position, just ideal the way you were there. Just a wee 2.2 raise, not 2.5, not 3, just 2.2. And don't. Oh, I thought you were in the small blind there. I never mentioned that in my notes, actually. I'm going to go back. No, right, pause there. Right, I'm back. I was just thingamajigging there. I remembered Rick's small blind patient of calling. Oh, where are we? It was good one. Right, we're up the top now. Alright, what's going to happen here? I must admit, the donk in me would possibly call, but it is a fold. In fact, it's 100% a fold. It's never, ever, 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 ever a call. Never, ever. It's a re-raise. Or it's a fold, but you're out of position. Again, this is an important thing, Rick. Blinds, when you're in the blinds, you're disadvantageous because everyone's got position on you. And as I say, with poker, it's well says, it doesn't matter how much importance you put on position, you're not putting enough importance on position. Position, 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 position is all you can actually just play. See, if you played every hand in position, you would probably just win money. Position again, most donks don't even know what position is, but if you don't know what position is, you need to know position. Position is paramount. You don't want to be calling hands, you don't mind being the aggressor out of position. You want to finish the pot now, here, maybe make it 1,000. And hopefully he could just run a steal. I wouldn't be folding all the time, but the donk time in me would call. But that's me playing like a donk, I must admit. And I've got a feeling you're going to call here. Oh, well, I'll shut up. I wouldn't have played that either. That was good. As I say, you didn't call, which is good. A raise would have been fine. But as I say, sometimes, yep. There on the button, Rick, I think you have to raise that 100%. It's actually not a bad hand, really. There, make it 4-4-4. These guys, if you've got position again, because you've got the button, you've got position, which means that you get to see what goes on every after the flop. On the flop, you play last, so you can control the size of the pot. You can control. You see what other people are doing. If somebody puts a big bet in the thing, but they are 100% of the time. I mean, it's so 2009 or 2008. Everyone raises their button. Sometimes you actually feel shit, people, because that's actually not a bad hand because you've got position in these two. But I would say with a hand like Jack Nine, that's I mean, people raise with junk Jack Twos and that in the button. I don't recommend that. That's like. Everybody was doing that, but nowadays Jack Nine's quite a reasonable hand. I would certainly make that 4-4-4. Take a flop, and as I say, you'll get one fold. You got probably got a caller. The flop will come. You'll miss the flop. He'll check. You'll see bet. You'll take it down, and you've just added another 500 chips to your stack. If he comes over the top when you raise on the button, because hey, he's on the button, he must be at it. Then you can just fold. But certainly a hand like Jack Nine, Jack Eight, I don't know, quite a lot of hands. I would probably say about 40% of the hands you get dealt, I would be raising with on the button. So I think you missed a wee spot there. Certainly missed a spot there. Same again here, a wee raise, right? Good, but your raises are too. It's too big, I would say, Rick. I mean, that's the thing. It's say 450 would have been fine there. Certainly not more than five. You don't want to, never over 2.5. I'd say 2.2, if you can keep it to 2.2 or thereabouts, just over thing, especially in a position like that, because you've got a hand that really can't stand a re-raise. You'd have to fold to a re-raise, so you don't want to just lose them extra chips. But it's good that you're raising, but I would certainly make about 450. I tend to, just for ease sake, say if it's like 200, I make it 444. If it's 300, I'll make it 666. That seems to be the hang. It doesn't matter if I've got aces or if I've got ace five suited, it's the same thing. But again, I not anything about it, but I would say to try and just 2.2, that's all you need to remember. Hey, I'm raising, let's make it 2.2, that's it. There is certain circumstances, especially if you've got not a bad hand and you've got a right collie donk, you would make it three, even four or whatever to try and get them to call. But in general, make it maybe 450, 444. Just as I say, if somebody come over the top of you there, you'd have to fold, and I know it doesn't sound like a lot, but you've saved them extra chips. I say, I'm just anything that I think's wrong, I'm just saying that. And if anyone thinks anything I'm saying is wrong, then please comment. I would like to be, I must admit, I've learnt what I've learnt. And I'm quite confident. And again, there, Rick, I would be raising that's definitely 444 that in the button. So you definitely need to raise more buttons. And also know why the button's such an important thing. A lot of people don't even know the things, but to realise that when you're on the button, you've got position and it's a lovely spot to be in. Now, here is an absolutely horrible spot. 200, so he's all got a big stack. There, I must admit, it's a horrible spot. He's got you covered as well. I wouldn't like to, but I think there's nothing wrong with a fold there. Nothing too wrong with a call there, but it is like a 15th of your stack or something. Nines I would call there, but eights is always about my limit that I start to under the gun raises and things. I start to all ins, I start folding. But I'm not going to slag you for it because in my time I've been the same. Right, he checks. If he's a checking, I'm a betting. I think he's possibly trapping you, but I think you have to. If he checks to you there, he could just be a donk that doesn't see bet, doesn't know. I think 100% of the time, you could still have the best hand. I mean, you could have ace king, you could have ace jack. A lot. I think you have to put in maybe about 700 there. And if he comes over the top, then at least you know where you stand with your rates. Oof, well, that's nice. That's again, though, right? I think the sizing might have been. That's 1400 in there. It's the same thing. He's going to fold to any bet sort of size. So I would just half pot it, maybe 700. I think, because if you've given an extra 400 chips there. If he'd have came over the top of you there again, you're going to have to fold, and yeah, it's another 400 chips. I bet about 700 would have done the same, exactly the same job. There, really. I was going to say he might hang about with a flush thing, but he'd have bet a flush draw on the flop and on the turn. So 700 there, I think, would have been better. But at least you bet, which is good. This is what it comes to as if you're some whatever. Sorry, Rick. But hey, we're all learning. It was a horrible spot, and I think you played that actually all right the way it worked out. But it's easy just to see two because you were he's under the gun and you're early position two. Situations like that, when the stacks are like whatever, it's actually not bad just to fold and wait for a better spot. Pair of eights are okay to raise way and to shove way, but they're not really that great a hand to. In fact, funnily enough, let's just go back to it. The old rule, 10 and 5, we can employ here. with the eight. So he raises that. So, and he's got 10,000 behind. So it's costing you 500. And how much are you going to win if you. That's. Remember, the rule of 10 and 5 is if you're caught with small pairs, is if it's costing you more than 10% of your stack, or if he, as in you can win only 10%, say if he had only 600 chips there, 500 chips. Then it's and I'm not making much sense here, but remind me, the rule of 5 and 10 basically is if it's costing you less than 5% of your stack and you're going to win, like, well, it's a thing, but rule of 5 and 10, talk to me about it there. I don't think you were actually getting the odds to set mine there, really. The most you get 8,500, you're getting 15 or something to one in your money, and really you want about 17 to 20 to one on the on small pairs. But and I think that would have been enough if you had a bigger stack and he had a bigger stack, then it would have been a call with the eights. But he, as I say, the most you can win is what, about 14 to 1 or something in your money because you've got 8,000. It's a little bit below. If you were getting, if he had got 20,000 and you had 16,000, then wow, I mean, if you got a set, you double up, you're getting something like, you're getting like 20 to 1, 25 to 1 or something in your money. So I think that probably makes that a fold, to tell you the truth, due to your stack size. So the rule of 5 and 10, if it's below 5%, it's a fold. If it's above 10%, no, if it's below 5%, it's a call. If it's above 10%, it's a fold. And anything between 5 and 10, it's a judgment call, really. So there, I would have said that was probably a fold there. But that's why, as I say, with poker, there's no set hard. There's it's situational. Here, you're right. The key point here before we even begin this hand is you're out of position. You don't want to be playing this hand out of position. Ace King out of position is just awful. You just don't want a horrible situation. And when you've got a big enough big stack, which is in there already, 880, just you're pushing 10 times the thing. I think you have to at least raise here. You can't call. You can't call, Rick. If you were on the button, or any, see that seat there, that seat, that seat, that seat, any of these seats here, calling with Ace King can be quite standard. 50% call, 50% raise, depending on the player. Because he's only min raised as well, I would have raised instead of just called. If somebody feed three times that and I was sitting in any of these seats here up to the button, I would have just called. But if he min raises it and I'm sitting in any of these seats here, I'm facing a min raise with Ace King, I'm re-raising it and I'm going to get it all in against Ace Queen, hopefully Ace Jack, or even race with a pair. But the big point here is you're out of position. You're going to be first to act. What are you going to do when you miss the flop? Here, I'd be booting it right up to 1,000 odd, and I'd be playing for my stack. You don't want to play hands out the blinds, out of position. So a good rule of thumb there is in the bl more prone to call raises when you're this side of the button, and when you're in the blinds, definitely just don't call. Raise, re-raise, raise, do the lot, but never, ever, 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 ever thing. I'd definitely boot that up, right up, maybe even 1,200. You just want to end the hand now. You don't want to play out of position. And see what's going to happen. He bets and you have to fold, and you probably had the best hand. So that's a good key point there, Rick. Don't play high. Well, I think I've explained it all. I've run out of time again, would you believe? I've seen part three.